VCR party time Tuesday night. Hooray!
We did it. Welcome. This time, Joe is in Los Angeles. I am in our office. You can't see it, though, because behind me is normally we've got 11,000 tapes in the office. But behind me right now is an Elf sleeping bag because we're prepped. George and I are prepped for tomorrow's Elfathon. 13 plus hours. We're watching 26 episodes of Elf in a row.
Why do you have the sleeping bag behind you? Like, why can't you just have?
It is a backdrop.
For ambiance?
Yeah, just for ambiance to promote our Twitch stream tomorrow at the address below. Go subscribe.
It looks great.
Thank you.
Great backdrop. That looks
far worse behind me. So this is thank me that I've got this because it's just garbage piled up.
I want you to pull it off so bad.
I'll show you by the end of the show. I'll pull this off. You can see what's behind me.
Okay.
There's not much to look at.
Do you want to jump in? No, I want to show something. We did a show in Los Angeles the other day and so met so many wonderful Melindas. Well, I met so many wonderful Melindas. Nick had to leave.
Yep.
And I did all the heavy lifting myself. Mm-hmm. But we got some submissions and take a look at this from 2001. Just Say Grow. Can you see that on there?
Oh.
Just Say Grow.
Yeah.
It's a medical marijuana video from 2001. And I love that cover art so much.
Me
Isn't
too.
That great?
I wish we'd had that
but
for,
then,
we're always looking for stuff to show on April 20th, 420, the marijuana cigarette holiday that everybody celebrates. And we can't find any good videos, but that might be it.
It could be the one. Then there's this one right next to it. Ross Perot, Straight Talk. Nick, dear Ross Perot impression.
Hey, I'm Ross Perot. How's that? You know how he would always say his name.
Yeah.
Yep.
But look, here's the best one. Here's the best. This one is specifically for you too, Nick.
Okay.
Tantric yoga, sexual kung fu for men. Look at this. It's a DVD, but it says warning, DVD contains full frontal nudity. And it says, Tantric Yoga and Sexual Kung Fu is an instructional video for men who are interested in developing vital energy and sexual skill. Nick Pruer.
Well, I don't know about that. But I did take karate in fourth grade, and I liked it.
Sexual karate?
No, just regular. No.
Tantric karate?
Just regular. So maybe that's the grown-up version. I don't know.
I'm excited for these. There's some good ones.
A couple arrived in the office. This is Simply Sushi, which is the art of preparing sushi. This could be pretty good. And this one, Evan sent this one. You know how we have napkin videos? This is Quick Napkin Creations by Nancy of Sewing with Nancy fame. So, don't have time to, you don't have a lot of time to make napkins. This is how you do it quickly.
Just like your boss is going to show up at the door in like 5 minutes.
Yeah.
5 minutes to make these napkins, pop in this tape. And you can impress your boss.
Well, in today's world, who has more time than that to make napkins? So, that's...
You get that raise you need.
Yeah, exactly. So I'm ready to pop that one in.
Hey, let's watch a Found Footage Festival classic, shall we?
Yeah.
You caught me with my pants down, but no one sells carpet or waterbeds for less...
Okay, so this one comes from Volume 9 of the Found Footage Festival. This is the one that we're still touring. We did it in Los Angeles last week, and we have a video. We have a public access montage in here, and it features a guy named Art Paul Schlosser, and he he's a street musician. You'll see him busk on State Street in Madison, Wisconsin. We've known him for a long time. Nick's known him since high school. And he had a public access show. And we've shown this a few times, but for people who haven't seen it, I think it's important that you see this
video. It's a classic for a reason.
So anyways, I'm painting.
And people think I can't paint without water. And
why would they think
that? It's
going
to be a little gross, but you might get desperate sometime. And
sure, Art. Sure you can. I'd like to see that.
You can paint without water? I'd like to see that.
You might want to know what to do if you get really desperate.
Did you hear the response in somebody? Like, when you have headphones on, you can hear things that you don't normally hear. Did you hear the guy in the background go, ugh?
Yeah.
You can take some of your spit there, and then you can paint. This is not always the best way to paint.
Not
some
always.
Some people will think this is gross.
Some people will think this is gross.
Some.
Just do you think that Mail City address still works? I've never even heard of Mail City.
I would say no.
Okay, so don't email artpaul@mailcity.com or do it. See.
I think it's gonna work.
See if it bounces back or not.
See, so
not the strongest spitter either. It's kind of falls out of his mouth more.
I'd say weak spitter.
See, so then you can just use your spit there. So anyways, that's something you could think of doing. Also, another thing you could do is if you really needed water and you were like at some place and they had water but you had nothing to contain it in, you could buy yourself a soda and then you could use the container.
Soda?
The container for the soda, and you could dip in, you know, after you drink it, of course. Although it might be interesting to have a painting soda pop as part of the.
Yeah. So okay. So here's the end result. We asked him to spit paint some scenes from Volume 9 from the show that we're currently touring. We're in the home stretch of it. And we asked him to depict some scenes with his spit paintings, and we've sold maybe, I would say, a couple dozen, probably.
Yeah, I'd and say we're officially Art Paul's art dealers.
Yeah, and they're actually selling pretty well. And I just asked him to do 5 more because I think I think we could sell them in this next like run of shows.
Sure.
And so he sent this one over, Martin Carlton jumping between 2 trees. I think he's getting better too with like his colors and his shading, and or maybe he's using more spit. Maybe he's using his can of soda idea. I don't know. This one he made. That's from the karaoke montage. The send in the clowns clown at the end. He picked
it's a good
that
photo.
Still
looks like
do.
His face. Yeah.
Yeah, it does. Yeah. Clearly in a library right now.
Mm-hmm.
But I emailed him a couple of weeks ago and I said, Art, we need 5 more paintings. Can you send them to me soon? And he responded, he said, sounds good, thanks. Oh, one question, do I spit on these also? And I said, yep, please spit on them all, thanks.
Mm-hmm.
So that was the correspondence.
Just standard correspondence. I mean, we have business correspondence like everybody else. Was this on Slack or was this on a project management software or what? How did you?
It was over Gmail. Yeah.
Email. Okay.
Oh, it was over Mail City.
Okay.
No, I just tried Mail City and it was sent back mail undeliverable.
Okay. Ah,
yeah. All right. One thing to promote for Art, he made an a cappella album called the Art Paul Project by various artists. Guess what? Various artists are on that Art Kapala Project. This guy and that guy. Yep.
That's right. We're on a CD.
We're on a CD. We're on this latest one. Our buddy Gabe Gronley, who's been on the show before, he's from Madison too. He did a documentary on Art Paul. He does a cappella on there too. I did My Mother's Reading a Book, which is one of my most favorite Art Paul songs of all time. What'd you do, song?
Drink Milk Rap, which was a rap that he did. And I did it in a death metal style growl.
Okay. So, yeah.
Yep.
You can find him
on Spotify, I think, too.
I don't know if this album's on Spotify, but okay. I remember him saying you could buy it on CD Baby.
Okay. It's probably on Bandcamp, too, I would guess. So
yeah.
Take a listen.
Take a listen for that.
Steve is our director. What do you have behind you today?
Well, I like that you're coming along and selling out as well. I appreciate the elf, but I'm selling out for Melinda Mike Mancuso, I believe is the name. And he's promoting the 10-year anniversary of their company. They make stuff for people to buy, the Yeti. And I went online, I saw it. They sell a lot of t-shirts. There's also this like a Yeti station where you can go play video games if you're ever in Aurora, Illinois. And definitely check it out. It's the Yeti.com. Theyette.com. And there's also yetistation.fun, yetirecords.com. But definitely check it out. It's really fun.
I like the logo. Happy 10-year anniversary. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, sweet.
I have some flying windows.
Wait. Support the Melindas that support us.
Right.
I love that catchphrase, Steve. That's a good one.
That's always a t-shirt gotta say right there.
You always got to say that at the end. Support the Melindas that support us.
I'm going to get on it.
Sorry for moving on before you could say it, Steve.
Yeah. Well, just a reminder, everyone, support the Melindas that support us.
There it is. Now we can get into some flying windows. This one comes from our pal Wayne, who submits a lot of stuff. She spotted some flying windows that were just right in front of me, but I didn't notice in one of the videos by D. Grunig, Magical Rainbow Sponge, played a lot of her, really dissected those tapes. But on one of her non-sponging videos, one of her stamping videos, there are some flying windows that open it up.
Cool.
So here's a submitted by Wayne. We've got...
Before we even see it, can I just make a prediction? I do not think these will be raw duggers because she is colorful. She likes colors. I think that these borders are going to be some of the best borders we've ever seen in our lifetimes.
What would you guess? Bordered windows or raw dogs, George, Steve?
I think there will be a rainbow around them or something.
I'm going to go bordered as well.
No way D is going to raw dog this fucker. There's no way.
Here's making marvelous memories with rubber stamps, courtesy of Wayne.
Be prepared to be entertained and delighted.
Raw doggers?
Raw dogs!
Has been creating original scrap.
There's a little board.
There's maybe a stroke, I guess. I don't know. Subtle at best.
Books and memory albums since she was a little girl.
It's kind of wild.
2 years after opening her first store selling rubber stamps in 1984, she introduced a class teaching scrapbooks called Awesome Album Art. It was a hit from the beginning and is still taught by her staff today. Now
that might disorient some viewers. We should put just a warning.
Well, that's spinning windows.
Yeah,
that's a different
segment. But this spinning window might disorient
some
viewers.
It was a hit from the beginning, and is still taught by her staff today.
We should have a warning at the beginning of all of our shows.
Great numbers into the wonderful discovery of the way rubber stamping when used with
buttons may disorient sensitive viewers. This is, I think, a. What do we call it? Squeeze?
Great numbers into the wonderful discovery of the way rubber stamping.
It's like a cube spinning.
A cube.
I think it's like a Rubik's Cube kind of a.
Discovery of the way rubber stamping, when used with boldness and imagination, can transform a memory album from ordinary to extraordinary.
Happy birthday.
See, that's what I thought the borders would look like right there.
Yes, that's what I would expect, but, you know. Shrinking pumpkins! okay. Making marvelous memories with rubber stamps. Thank you, Wayne, for letting
that.
Us know.
We did that. We just made some marvelous memories.
Those impressions were not posh. I'm going to say it because they were raw dogs. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. We need some like gold frames. Those are posh impressions.
If we ever get to interview D. Grunig, that's going to be my first question. I'm going to be like, why did you decide to go with a raw dog window on your flying windows instead of something more beautiful and bordered?
Interview's over.
Yeah. Do we have any celebrity bullshit this week? There's a lot.
As a matter of fact, we do.
No. Larry Hagman, Murray, Mike Ditka.
I mean, can you imagine being at a cocktail party with all five of those celebs? Like, how would that be?
Tinseltown's finest? Yeah, that would be heaven.
Yes, we're talking about Tinseltown's finest here. What would you talk to Larry Hagman about?
The afterlife. Isn't he dead?
Oh, is he?
Yeah. What happens when you die, Larry Hagman? You go to parties?
Okay, so this week, I forgot the goddamn tape. I'm not at home right now, and I had it set aside, and it has a great cover. It's called UFOs and channeling, and UFOs is apostrophe S. And is you're not allowed, right? That's incorrect, right?
I think in some circumstances it's okay, when otherwise if they were all caps it would look like UFOs.
Yeah,
what I mean,
exactly. So, exactly. Yeah, I think that it's okay, but it still looks a little weird.
Yeah,
UFOs and channeling, it's a video about that. It's a new agey kind of video. It's about an hour long.
I think I just found it, the cover. So
well, don't look. Well, but
well, I haven't looked
it,
at it.
See who the celebrity is.
I won't look at the celebrity. But should I just save it?
No.
Share it.
Oh,
that's what I'm saying. I can share it now
in post. Well, but people will see who.
Okay, I'll just put it up now.
Okay. There it is.
Yeah, there it is. Okay.
Okay. So this particular celebrity, let's see. He's best known for the lead in a 1970s cop show. He's always played tough guys. He has lots of movie credits, but only a few good movies. He has tons of movie credits. And I'm not going to give you his real first name yet because I think it'll give it away. Who do you guys think the celebrity is?
Eric Estrada.
Ooh, good one. I'll say Crockett, whatever his name is.
Davey?
No. As in
Phil Michael Thomas?
Yeah, Philip Michael Thomas.
Okay.
Although that was 80s, but all right.
I'm going to say Robert Blake.
Okay. All Ooh. Good guesses. All good guesses. Eric, here it is. This Week in Celebrity Bullshit, UFOs and Channeling.
I felt myself totally involved by a strange force. And
Nick,
I got
you believe
paralyzed.
In all this stuff, right?
Yeah. How is he painting without water? How is he doing it?
He's just spraying his spit all over wildly, like a sprinkler.
Spittoon to his right.
Savalas.
We're going to show you Kojak, how they change the way you think about life. It's called channeling. Well, look at what it is. Some of the people doing it. And the energies that appear to come through them. Hello.
This is another quarter that I wanted to
do. The delayed hello.
Yes, this is I want to do a This Week in Delayed Hellos. Where it's just like, this is the thing that we're going to be talking about. Hello, I'm Troy McClure. You might remember me from such, you know?
Right.
The delayed. I love the delayed hello.
Does he say, who abducts you, baby? At all this?
So for us, it would be like, this is the show where we watch 10,000 videos. If we're in the office, I'm Joe, that's Nick, that's Steve, that's George. Well, hello, Melendez. You know.
Oh,
so
yeah. Well, I think you have to do the introduction after you say the well, hello. This is a show where we watch 11,000 videos. I'm Joe.
Right. I see. Okay.
And welcome, Melendez, to VCR Party.
Yeah, okay.
It'd be something like that.
Something like that.
All right, let's see what else Savalas has to say.
Some of the people doing it, and the energies that appear to come through them. Hello, I'm Telly Savalas. But before we start, let's begin with a subject many of us are quite interested in. Contact with extraterrestrials and their civilizations.
Some good samples here. And it goes on like that. So this video is actually very good. I watched the whole thing the other day, and they do a lot of the channeling. Remember, we had that one video, that New Age video of that. Remember that woman who would she could become like a space alien.
She's a little girl, and then she
yeah, and she like died in Atlantis. There's a guy who can do that in here too. I'm thinking. Oh, excuse me. I think we have a montage here. That we can
just a channeling mine, montage,
a channeling montage, and then we have that other goofball that channels too, and people eat it up and ask them questions, and it's always fun
as their characters. Yeah,
as their characters. So I'll play some of that next week because it's pretty good.
Okay, great. Yeah, I see a great montage. Oh, let's show. Well, we're not doing traditional raviolis, right? We're gonna do state jingles. Okay.
We're doing state jingles. So let me just play the intro. Let's just make this official. This is George. I would say George's greatest intro graphic of all time.
State, Commonwealth, Commonwealth, state,
we're going to tackle Oklahoma today. Oklahoma, Oklahoma, Oklahoma. And I looked up what Oklahoma's known for, and it seemed like it was tornadoes in Buffalo mostly.
And not getting a lot of the COVID-19 vaccine. That's the other thing there.
They don't get a lot of, okay.
Very low vaccination rate.
Yeah. I'd like to thank CanStock for supplying all the clip art today. They gave it to me for absolutely free. I thought that was cool. And if you're wondering if there's a version of the tornado clip art that's wearing a Santa Claus outfit, you're absolutely right. They do have that. The CanStock has it all.
That was my next question.
Well, he has a goatee too. He doesn't have a beard. He has a goatee.
Yeah.
When would anybody have to use that?
Well, Christmas tornadoes.
Is there such a thing? Okay. All right. All right. And I think that's the same tornado, same eyes. No, actually the one has a tongue. This one has a tongue. All right.
So well, let's get to the bottom of this. I mean, which is it?
So I chose Oklahoma because this video came in, I think maybe last summer sometime, maybe like in June or so. And I just absolutely loved it. I played it during a flying window, but it really deserves much more attention. And this is the one that got me excited about Oklahoma. It's for a company called Christie's, and Honeydew Wilkins sent it in. Nick, you remember Honeydew Wilkins?
Mm-hmm.
What was Honeydew Wilkins' claim to fame?
His name's Honeydew Wilkins. I've always remembered that item.
Honeydew Wilkins introduced us to Not Gonna Dude It.
That's right. Oh, yes. Yeah. I should have remembered that. Yes. I'm sorry, okay. Honeydew. Yep.
All right. So Honeydew said this commercial was a staple of late night Oklahoma City TV in the early 90s. And I can't imagine any state jingle beating this one, but we'll see. Here it is.
Okay.
Christie's.
Christie's, Christie's Toy Box, where the fun begins. We've got cards for any occasion and lots of things.
It's basically
for
a jingle
your
for a Paul Bernardo job,
yeah.
Right?
For any occasion, they've got cards. Come for on like a in child's
and
birthday.
Browse around, because there's not another place like us in town.
If you need pasta Christie's with penises on it.
Don't go behind the beaded curtain, Christie's Spencer.
Toy Box.
Come to Christie's Toy Box.
So, Christie's where the fun begins. That's as good as it gets right there. Well, not so fast. John, he reached out. He used to work for a TV station in Oklahoma City for a few years, and he sent us some Oklahoma classics. And then I started wondering, like, oh, I think this Mr. Spriggs, it's for a barbecue joint. It might actually beat Christie's. I didn't think it was possible, but listen to this. And this is a great video. It's a great commercial too.
Mr. Spriggs Barbecue.
It's always
Mr. Spriggs Barbecue.
Tender.
Mr. Spriggs Barbecue.
Falls off the bone.
Mr. Spriggs Barbecue. Spriggs Barbecue. Mr. Spriggs Barbecue.
It's always
Mr. Spriggs Barbecue.
Tender.
Mr. Spriggs Barbecue.
Falls off the bone.
Mr. Spriggs Barbecue. Mr. Spriggs Barbecue.
Oklahoma's best barbecue.
Oh,
Mr.
Wow.
Spriggs.
Yeah, that's a good one. And it has words. I felt like that annoyed you too because of the calling it tender and saying it falls off the bone.
I was going to hide a spotlight that falls off the bone does not sound good to me. But I mean, if you're a barbarian in Mongol China, sure, you'd want something that falls off the bone. Otherwise, wow. And also, I don't like watching people eat in general, but especially not those people. No. I mean, it's just kind of corporate.
Well, especially barbecue, because it's always a mess. I mean, there's a reason they give you a roll of paper towels at your table. There's a reason for it. Because there's like filth all over your mouth constantly.
George, were you going to chime in there? I'm sorry.
I was just trying to figure out what falls off the bone would mean as a double entendre. I can't wrap my mind around it.
Yeah, but, penis.
No, I'm sorry. I just
ejaculate, maybe.
All right, let's move on.
Well, we have a title for the episode.
Well, we'll have several warnings at the beginning of this one, not just about that spinning window.
I think that could actually work though, George. We'll talk about it after the show. All right, next one. BC Clark anniversary sale. John said this is easily the most recognizable and well-known jingle of all time in Oklahoma City. It's been running every holiday season since 1956. So this one has staying power. So maybe okay. This is the best one. It also has some shitty animation. So
jewelry is the gift to give.
I thought it was legging, but no, that's the animation.
Oh, okay.
I thought maybe my Wi-Fi was acting up, but no, it's the animation.
Well, it's 50s animation, so.
Yeah. Gift to give.
Because it's the gift that lives and lives.
So give the gift to reindeer.
Right, look down the hill.
Is this tornado Santa or regular Santa?
All right, listen to the song. Listen closely.
Because it's the gift that live and live.
So give the gift you know can't fail.
From BC Clark's anniversary sale. Most sales are after Christmas, but Clark's is just before.
Most everything is marked way down.
Savings you can't ignore. At Oklahoma's oldest jeweler since 1892.
So give the gift you know can't fail.
From BC Clark's anniversary
That's
sale.
Professional. That's as professional as the jingle is going to get. Yeah. I mean, like, that's 30 seconds, too. They got a lot in on 30 seconds.
I like that one a lot. I thought it was great.
From the 1950s.
No overweight people were eating barbecue in it. There's a lot to recommend.
My understanding is that Otis is the son of that jingle and a tornado.
Oh, which tornado? The Santa one or the regular tornado?
Unknown. The one with the tongue.
Okay, yeah, that'd be Santa.
Santa tornado, yep.
All right, what's your favorite so far? Who's your leader? Christie's, Mr. Spriggs Barbecue, or BC Clark anniversary sale?
I'm torn right now between Mr. Spriggs and Christie's. I think it's going to be a game time decision.
Oh, really? BC Clark did nothing for you?
Too well done. Not enough character.
Oh yeah, you like shit.
Well, yeah. I mean, that's okay. Have you seen the show?
True. All right. So Tall Paul. John said a friend's dad actually wrote and performed this. So he knows the guy whose dad wrote this. Okay. Maybe we could get him on the show. Maybe we could. They started running these in the early 80s, late at night on UHF TV stations, which UHF, didn't that movie took place in Tulsa, Oklahoma?
It did.
Yeah. So UHF TV stations, maybe that's a big thing there.
Okay.
I don't know.
I want to like this one.
So he said that this Tall Paul commercial became so popular, the office staff had trouble keeping up with all of the phone calls the day after they aired. Now, I don't know what the phone calls about how they wanted to buy the product or about just compliments about how great the song was. That's what I don't understand. It didn't. John didn't say.
We'll have to follow up depending on how this does.
Yeah. Okay. Here it is. Here's Tall Paul.
Hi folks, Tall Paul here. When it comes to protecting what you own, always remember.
Protecting all the things you own, like cars, trucks, and mobile homes. With accidents or tickets too, call and we'll take care of you. 524-1541.
I've got monthly payments you can holler about
so
too.
I feel like that's a good one for Oklahoma because it's kind of country-ish, it's kind of western-ish.
Oklahoma has a very high pedigree of jingles so far. This might be the strongest batch.
Well, I think we have an excellent curator. John is an excellent curator. He worked in TV, so he's seen all these. And so that's but yeah, you're right. This is pretty great. Drabeck and Hill. So they have one of those that's just at the end of the commercial. And I just looped it a few times so you could hear this one. It's kind of classic. It rings of Otis. There's maybe a little bit of Otis here. Mm-hmm. But here's Drabeck and Hill.
In our industry, we have codes.
And this is Drabeck saying this, who's the owner of the place.
Okay.
So he says, we have, listen closely.
In our industry, we have codes. We have what we call the Drabeck and Hill standard. And that exceeds all the other
codes. Did the other people in the industry use that term? He said, in our industry, we have terms. So does like a competitor use the Drabeck and Hill standard? Guys?
I thought he was saying codes.
Codes.
I thought he said like there are professional codes and then there's our codes, which exceed.
Oh, okay. I got you. All right. Let me listen to it again with new ears.
In our industry, we have codes. We have what we call the Drabeck and Hill standard, and that exceeds
okay, so his code
all
is better
the
than
other codes.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And now let's watch the penguin chip the ice. I think we've examined that quite enough.
The Oklahoma Penguin.
That is a border flying, border stationary. Chain,
oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. All right, here we go. Listen closely.
Yeah, codes.
That's what you want in a jingle, right there.
Catchy.
Okay.
Catchy. Yep.
It's good. It's good. Right. Oklahoma, I'm telling you. They got it. They got it figured out. All right, we got one more, and this is for bronze. This is a beautiful, you know, every so often, like that's a fun, like, peppy toe tapper kind of one, but sometimes they'll bring out, like, a beautiful one, like, what's that one insurance one that I always like from Rockford? Harkness Insurance, where it's
Harkness Insurance.
Exactly, where it's a beautiful song. This is a beautiful song for the first half, but then the second half, they start, you know, talking about it, and it gets boring. So I added some sound effects to some of the visuals there.
Just
part, so that part wouldn't get boring.
Okay.
Okay. All right, here we go. So here's Brahms.
From our farm to our store, only Brahms gives you more.
You'll enjoy more delicious toppings on Brahms Fruit Sundaes. Delicious strawberry, tangy peach, or pink cherry, whipped cream, and a cherry on top, too. You always get so much more with a fruit sundae the way we make them at your neighborhood Brahms.
What do you guys think? Did that help it out?
Yeah. Gaunga horn. And
subtle.
I could have gone with a few more chomps, but other than that, I thought, yeah, it was great.
So just when you guys are voting for the Brahms, just note that those sound effects were mine and don't let that factor in to the song at all. So what do you guys think? What's your favorite? Christie's, Mr. Spriggs, B.C. Clark Anniversary Sale, Tall Paul, Dre Beck and Hill, or was it Brahms?
Well, I want to go to Brahms because the original commercial had all those sound effects in it, and I really like it.
No.
What?
I just explained. I just
Oh.
No, we're not allowed to do that. No,
not it has not,
this isn't a sound effect contest. This is a state jingle contest.
Got momentarily confused.
Yeah.
All right. Now, I'm still debating because Mr. Spriggs, I really like Mr. Spriggs. I feel like barbecue is very emblematic of Oklahoma.
True.
But Christie's is for a series of adult novelty stores, and it shows men and women shopping for greeting cards in it. Oh, look, it's a fat lady in lingerie. Should I get that? I mean, it's like, what are they looking at?
I know, it's tough. This isn't. Yeah.
You know what? This might surprise you. I'm going to go with Mr. Spriggs. That's my pick.
Okay, I guess it doesn't surprise me that much. It's a great song,
and
everything. Yeah, but you just because it disgusted you.
It disgusted
right?
me.
With the tender and the falls off the bone talk and all that kind of stuff.
Yep.
Seeing people eat. You're going Spriggs. What about you, Steve? Steve, what are you leaning towards?
I think this was one of our stronger states that we've had. I was blown away, but I think I got to go with Mr. Spriggs as well. I just felt like that. I don't know. It just captured me.
Yeah. And you seem like a barbecue kind of guy too. Right?
100%. Although I felt like the combination of the, you know, sultry song or however you want to say it. And then with the people just eating food did not do it for me at all. I felt like that. Not how I wanted to see my food.
Right. But it's not about that with the state jingle tournament. Yeah,
exactly. But the song got me.
George.
Well, I was going to go with Christie's, but then I heard in the lyrics, it said, there's no place like it in the city or something like that, while they were showing that there were four locations. So if you're in any one place, there are three other places in the city like it. The song's lying. So I have to go with Mr. Spriggs. It's a clean
unanimous
sweep.
Wow. Yeah. Well, wait a second. I haven't weighed in yet, guys.
Well, I was going to ask you, what do you think?
I'm going with Christie's. I think Christie's is my first love. Mm-hmm. And I saw Spriggs and I got really excited. And that's when I decided to do Oklahoma as the state jingle to curate that one. But then after watching it with you guys and I was just like, Christie's my first love. So yeah. I'm going back to Christie's. So
I mean, any other state, Brahms would win. I mean, even Drabeck and Hill, but Oklahoma, stiff competition. So
you don't think Tall Paul?
I do like Tall Paul. I like the sort of stop motion animated mouth and stuff. But
do you think we'll get phone calls tomorrow morning saying how much people like it? You think we'll get phone calls first thing tomorrow morning?
Tall Paul defenders, you mean?
No, people who love it. I mean, because that's what the friend's dad got all those phone calls.
I bet we're going to get a lot of, I think we'll get a lot of opinions. So weigh in, go to our patreon.com/foundfootagefestival. The poll will be up right now and go ahead and vote. You have until next Tuesday night at 5:00 Eastern time. And we will award, not only will we award the official state jingle based upon your voting, we will have our pal Judah here make a state flag. So let me just recap some of the flags we've got. This is Warwick Mall from Rhode Island.
Rhode Island, yeah.
This is a Tasty Cake from Pennsylvania. Here Beautiful. We have New York, Genesee Cream Ale. I like it.
We got to make postcards of these. That's what we have to something. Make, postcards. Yeah.
Something that's easy to produce 50 of, you know?
Hard to explain postcards.
Yeah. Yes. This is Menards, $688, Wisconsin. Yes. Oh, and I just noticed that Ray from Menards is the face of
the face on there. Yeah. Yes.
And then this is the most recent one that Steve curated. It's Hawaii. This is KEVU The Look. So
wow.
Yeah, so that's it. And we'll find out what Oklahoma's state flag is next week.
I'm trying to think what would make the best state flag. I feel like would Christie's make the best state flag or would Mr. Spriggs make the best state flag?
I don't know. A corpulent
man.
Make the
argument for Tall Paul.
Yeah, Tall Paul would be great on a flag.
Yeah, he'd look great on a flag. Yeah.
Well, weigh in. This
penis pasta would look great on any flag.
That's true. But let us know. Let us know what you think. Patreon.com. You don't have to be a patron to vote. So weigh in now. Cyber video time. This is the segment of the show where we venture outside of VHS and TV commercials, and we get into cyber videos that we can find on the internet. And here's how to watch them. Let's start with George.
Oh, well, as you know, I've been looking at 976 and 900 lines for several weeks, months maybe by now. And
I think it's years. I think it's year two.
Yeah. And I've archived dozens and dozens of 976 dating line ads, and they're all pretty similar, but of those, I've picked three from the 80s that are the most 80s to me, and I've ordered them in increasing 80s-ness.
Okay.
On this installment of 976,
this may be the most shocking phone call you'll ever make.
Bored again? Interested in a new way to meet people? Just pick up the phone and dial
1-976-8585.
What are you waiting for? Get on the party line!
1-976-8585.
You're saying that was the most 80s?
That was the of the 80s, that was 80s-ish. The hanging phones was very 80s. But these, it's the least of the three.
Oh, okay, it's going to get more 80s. Gotcha. Yeah.
Ever tried calling one of those phone lines you see advertised on TV? You never know who's going to be on the other end.
Hey, Ma, can I borrow the Harley?
Hurry back, it's bingo night.
I haven't felt good in years. Germs.
Kids? Nah, I hate kids. Oh, you got two of them. I love them.
Don't you really want to talk to those people? My friends and I call 976-HOTT. It's Atlanta's hottest new teen party line.
So that was very 80s. Those were 80s jokes, right? Very
80s
jokes. You can't do that on television sort of style.
Or like whoever directed You Gotta Fight for Your Right to Party directed that.
Yes.
Yeah.
But now, aesthetically, this is the most 80s.
Hey,
280.
Call the Gab line. It's a party line.
It's another warning. Now. We need to have 280s.
1976
GABB. I mean, it almost looks like a parody.
Yeah. The amount of neon in that actually hurt my eyes.
Yeah, wow. Is the well running dry, George, or how are you doing with those?
I am scraping the bottom of the barrel. I came up with a totally different dial-a-joke set that I scrapped at the last second.
Oh.
Why? Why'd you scrap it?
Well, I got it for next week, I guess.
Oh, okay.
It's not going to waste.
Oh, good, good.
Steve, what do you have on tap for us?
Continuing with Jock Shams, which is where we take commercials featuring athletes. This one goes back to the 80s, was sent in by Ross. And let me know what you guys think.
Okay, and we're still seeking jingles for Jock Shams, right?
No, well, we have one. I just
have
to put
one?
It together.
Oh, okay. Yes. Okay, good. This might be 280s, too.
Oh, this is so... Yeah. Chugging some Kool-Aid.
Okay, rookie. Play ball.
Yep, they got Pete Rose in there to
disgraced baseball great. Yeah.
Oh, wow. I bet he said some inappropriate things around the kids and the Kool-Aid man.
I'm sure he
did. On the set, I'm sure he did.
A safe bet.
You remember the video? We have a Pete Rose, like, how to hit baseballs video where it really feels like he's making it up as he goes along, and he has a lot of flubs in there, and you know the director is probably too scared to tell him to retake some stuff, and so the video is just it's pretty bad.
Yeah, it's like, you know, he's like, go get into a natural stance. I mean, everybody's stance is different. I mean, some people like to sleep on their side, some people like to sleep standing up. Their grandma sleeps standing up, you know, and you're like, what? But he just keeps talking. And you paid $45 for this instructional baseball tape.
His analogies usually don't work.
No.
And the kids are just left confused. But good old Pete Rose. I'm sure that.
Yeah.
What do you think he did with that? What do you think he did with that Kool-Aid money?
Put $700 to throw a game, I would guess. Occasionally, I'll just like have a muse, some like a phrase or something that I'll wonder if something exists on YouTube for the cyber video segment. And I kind of woke up with the phrase recycling rap in my head. And lo and behold, there is recycling rap. And it's looks like a high school and middle school class were tasked with for Earth Day putting together recycling raps. And this is from a local news station in Zanesville, Ohio. And the video, at first I thought it was like the way I was editing it, you know, pulling it into my editing program that was making it kind of clip, but no, that's just how it was uploaded. So you have to bear with some of the skipping in it, but it's still worth watching. You know how we've done news appearances that are awkward and gotten in trouble for it?
Yeah.
How's no one in trouble for this?
Welcome back. Katrina Carpenter joins us from the Perry County Recycling Program. And we've got some students from Perry County Schools as well. We'll get to these folks here in a minute. But Katrina, this is part of a program that you kind of launched last year to get a little interest into the school districts to find out a little bit more about recycling. Tell us about it.
That's right. We started thinking out of the box, thinking what could we do that involves the students within Perry County to present their view of reducing waste and recycling more, mm-hmm. and put it in the format of a rap presentation. And so in the
performance, we decided now that'd be a bad idea. We decided we scrapped
project
it.
Is to be heard hopefully to more than just the people within their school building and beyond here live at noon, and hopefully that message goes to heart and people think twice about what they do with their waste.
She worked with Fab Five Freddy, like back in the early New York, like underground days, right? She
for
was like,
Fab Five Freddy's rap presentations. Yeah.
Right. Here's the one in the vest I remember in the video.
Yeah. What do you think about the body language of the kid in the middle, too? You think
he's the coolest one. I think he's actually the coolest one there.
He kind of has an Eminem rap style. You hear it, although it skips. And I think she kind of runs out of steam in her sentence here. And just kind of, and we hope this does this at here at noon. And it gets out, you know, it's just kind of like.
That they project is to be heard hopefully to more than just the people within their school building and beyond here live at noon. And hopefully that message goes to heart and people think twice about what they do with their waste.
All right, well.
That sentence didn't end. That sentence would never the never-ending sentence.
Go with your heart and think twice.
I feel like that's how I talk most of the time on the show, where it's just like, oh, I guess there's another sentence. Oh, look at this sentence is still going.
Project is to be heard, hopefully, to more than just the people within their school building and beyond here live at noon. And hopefully that message goes to heart and people think twice about what they do with their waste.
All right. Well, we've got Austin Campbell here from Crooksville. You won the high school division.
Looks like he's up to no good.
What, I guess, inspired you to kind of enter this? Was this just something you thought, hey, it's a cool project, I like doing videos, and so you kind of threw it together? How'd this all come about?
Don't guess.
Was it a project you were assigned as part of a class, or was it just something that you really just
this will
thought,
be an interesting
yeah, I want to
answer.
Give this a try? Yeah.
No, like the teacher that helped me get into it helped me get into another rap before, so I figured might as well. Nice to see Michael do use and recycle because fact he likes to drive and stand it. Use Michael and it's supposed to use bicycle.
Wait, this is how it is on the internet video. Okay. That's what I was saying. It skips. This is how it skips. I mean, it's this fast, but it's skipping a little bit. Yeah.
I didn't think it would be this bad.
Yeah, it's this bad.
Back it up. I want to see it from the beginning.
It almost makes it more interesting. Like, this could be a new, like, Chopped and Screwed is kind of a style. Maybe this becomes a new style.
Right, yeah.
Rap production.
Nice to see Michael do use and recycle because fact he likes to drive and stand it.
You can kind of see the lyrics. Because the fact that he
lands it's supposed to use bicycles to back the island, he asked not to recycle your aluminum cans. If you do land in your man, we use the paper by riding. I reduce footprint without leaving light on. Turn the light off, sign line off. Be sure to recycle. And if you are not, then just your problem. It's out, Austin. It's not good, but if you'd like to know, you should recycle newspaper. I'll talk to you later.
I'll talk to you later. Filmed on location at Crooksville High School.
Do you think that that's how it aired on the station?
I don't know, but this had almost as many views as an IMG. It had like 3 views. And I think the teacher uploaded it.
I love Austin Campbell's rap name.
Yeah.
AKA Soup Riot.
Soup Riot. Yeah.
My understanding is he was killed in a drive-by by Neat Pete.
Oh, really? Of the Neat Pete Shuffle?
There was a beef between Huntsville and Crooksville High.
What about these are middle schoolers here. Reduce, recycle, word. I thought that was kind of cool pose that they did.
That's skipping too, though, right?
Yeah, yeah. So, it all skips past a certain point in this, yeah.
Okay, but then once it goes back.
It still skips a little bit, yeah. But this was so good. I was like, what am I going to do, throw out the baby with the bathwater? No,
I'm saying the skips add to it.
Yeah, all right.
Skips are the best part of this whole thing.
All right.
Just to end with this project, the enthusiasm that the students show is wonderful. And taking it beyond the classroom, what we're really looking at, and that's what you achieve.
Yeah. Okay. So
it might be the most unwatchable thing on the internet.
That's what I think I've discovered. That's what I think I've discovered.
Number one.
And why I wanted to show it so badly tonight on Cyber Videos. I saved it for second to last because I knew.
Nick, maybe that's your new corner. Like you find the most unwatchable videos on the internet. Like that's Nick's unwatchable corner.
Reduce, cycle. Yep. Bunch of rappers. All right.
Word.
Did everybody go? My turn?
Yeah, it's up to IMG time. Yeah.
All right, let's do it.
Chicken shit. Electronic video transmission. Uploaded with no intention. Harvested semi-ethically. Welcome to IMG.
All right, IMG time. We got some good ones this week. Who do we got? First one coming up here. We got IMG 3483. Daniel found this one. 188 views. But I think the reason it has 188 views is because it features a mayor of, I think, a small town in Colorado. Mm-hmm. And I'm just guessing. But Daniel called it Nervous Mayor. And you'll see why they call it Nervous Mayor. Listen, there's a flub up top, too.
Oh,
so and I wonder if this is like the final take or if this is a first take that they accidentally put up. Who knows?
Hi, my name is Matt Salka, Mayor of Bayfield, Colorado. I want to welcome to our community.
I want to welcome to.
Right.
He should have said, I want to welcome you to.
Right.
You think he's nervous? This is maybe his first YouTube video?
His first IMG. That's
right. Yeah. Welcome to the club.
Hi, my name is Matt Salka, Mayor of Bayfield, Colorado. I want to welcome to our community. We have a great town. It's a family-oriented town. We love our local businesses, and we take pride in our parks. And welcome.
What do you think of the expression at the end after he finished? He kind of hurried that welcome.
And, yeah. He went from the same school of broadcasting as the teacher on the recycling rap video, I think. And, keeps talking even when he's run out of things to say.
He makes that like just tense face, like every muscle's flexed in his face. I do that all the time on conference calls. If I say something dumb on a conference call, I just like, yeah, I do that same face. All right. So that's a good one. Thank you, Daniel. IMG 3198. Flash sent this one. Flash is an all-star IMG-er. 8 views. Flash called this one, This Is Why We Have Ants. I love this one.
This is why we have ants, honey. Because you refuse to clean up after yourself. See this? They're all over the place because of this. That's from you.
That's from you. What? Please explain to me. Why did she put that up? Why was that uploaded? What that's why I always say accidental uploads.
I think why that is the case for in a lot of these, but I don't know. We'll never know. Maybe that's part of the mystery and magic
even like,
of IMG.
Even like Nervous Mayor, there's no way he wanted that to go up. He was not happy with that take, right?
No.
But it still went up. Okay. Just trying to wrap my head around these IMGs still. I've been doing them for like 5 years now, and I still don't understand how they work. IMG 2981, our final one. Derek sent this 120 views. It's called Jingle Bells. This will certainly be featured in our holiday show IMG segment this year. Not bad.
Good.
Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle
bells, jingle this is the kind of dancing I think I could actually pull off.
Oh, yeah? Sitting?
No other kind, but yeah, sitting.
But just moving your arms?
Yep.
And only your arms? Excuse me.
Yeah.
Nice.
Rocks are done. Gotta sleep.
Okay, there we go. Fine. Those are your IMGs and those are your cyber videos on the internet.
Right. Up next, nice things.
Ooh, that wasn't great.
Yeah, maybe just do it with a little more enthusiasm, a little bit more passion, Steve.
Yeah, a little more passion.
Do this at the end.
Try one more time.
Up next, nice things.
All right, these are things that we find nice. And the first thing I want to share is that I was at Gen Con, the board game convention, showing off my board game Dreamcatcher. And I had several people.
Whoever catches the most dreams, they're the dream master,
exactly.
Right? Okay.
And I had several people come up to me throughout the week and say, hello, Melinda. And they were big VCR party and found footage festival fans. And Krista and Will came and they played Dream Crush and nice. they made their own and they had a lot of fun at the convention. So it was actually good seeing some Melindas in person there.
That's great.
Indianapolis. So thanks for coming up and saying hi.
Melindas are everywhere.
They are.
They're everywhere.
Yes.
You can't escape them. Like I said, at the LA show, there were Melindas galore. And a couple Melindas, I forgot their name. I always forget their names. I got to start remembering names better. But a couple, they were on their way walking to the show. And on the ground, they found a nice thing. And they gave it to me. It was a thank you card. Check it out. Here's the thank you card. Hallmark put it out. Maybe you heard of them. It said, and then on the inside, you open up, it says, Thanks for nothing, ass clown.
We're going to send that to Found Magazine. That's a good one.
Yeah, it's the old bait and switch. You're like, oh, thank you. That's so nice. And then all of a sudden you open up, you're like, what?
That's good.
Yeah.
That is a nice definite thing. Nice thing.
Yeah.
Cinematic sent us a box that he wanted us to open on the show. I have no idea what's in this, but I did some pre-ripping of it. It's fragile. This came all the way from England. This is Matt from the UK. So, he's awarding us stuff.
Oh, okay. All right. What's the occasion? Just like award season? Oh, yeah. The Emmys were last weekend. And
I guess
yeah,
so, yeah.
That's the tie-in.
For services to all things tedious, IMGs, and filth, I award Joe the Filth Corner Trophy of 2021. Please open
yes.
box one. All right.
Let's see. It's like a board game.
Yeah, it is. Whoa, look at it. It's an actual award. This says the Golden Filth Award.
What?
Look at this.
Oh,
the Golden Filth Award.
I'm putting that behind my desk. Oh, that's beautiful.
Wow.
Yeah, cool. I did it.
All right.
Oh, I finally got it. I thought George was getting it this year for sure, but
for inventing Plunkets in quarantine and being an all-around nice guy, I award the Save the Thumbs Trophy to, I don't know, I assume this is to Steve Lawrence, but we'll see.
We'll see. Again, I think it's George. I think George has this one wrapped up.
The Thumbs Up Award. Here it is, the Thumbs Up Award
what?
For Steve Lawrence.
Where did he get these things?
Well done.
That's incredible.
Thank you, Cinematic.
They have a nice thing store in England.
Oh, they do. Yeah.
Getting VHS detecting VIN number finding and all-around general creepiness, I award George the Cheeky Monkey. This is box 3. This is a bigger box. Wow. This is really involved, Matt. Thank you. What if I just didn't get an award? It's like, and that's it.
That'd be the best.
The Cheeky Monkey Award. This goes
nice.
To George. Some foam balls on that. But that's a good one. I really like that monkey
good.
One.
Yeah, now George is going to have to sterilize that since you put your hand all over it.
Oh, yeah. Forgot about that. Yeah. For never, ever failing to make me smile with laugh and quick-witted quips, the amazing sense of humor, I award Nick the...
It's got to be me. It's Nick.
This is some kind of
which,
other...
Which Nick?
Prewer says.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh.
This is for my all-around quips. This is the comedy award. Wow. Look at comedy. I got the comedy award, guys.
Nick, will you put that on your LinkedIn?
Yeah,
that
absolutely.
That you are the recipient of the comedy award.
Cinematic comedy award, yeah. And that says, and then thank you guys for helping out. This is a golden ticket, the open last. Whoa, look at this. Can you see this says bunion surgery, both spelled?
Oh, yeah, lift flap.
Yep, and it says lift flap. And what does it say there? It's focusing.
Thanks for nothing, ass clowns.
Oh, it says a free one-way ticket out of this hellhole.
Yeah,
this is it. This is our
we
golden ticket. All right, well, you're witness the last episode of VCR Party. Thank you, Matt. You got us out of this hellhole. These are really special.
Cinematic
so
nailed
you.
It. Cinematic nice absolutely nice nailed it. Wow.
Those are all nice things, and we all deserve those words.
And they're all 100% gold, right?
Yes.
Like, okay, good.
George, you were in the office today prepping for the Alphathon, and you got a package. You don't get a lot of mail at the office, but you got a package today.
Yeah, and I opened it up, and there was a T-shirt featuring the periodic table of metallic dragons from Dungeons and Dragons, and I had to use some detective work because there was no note in it, and found that it was from Wayne.
Oh, nice. Who gave us the flying windows?
Yes. So,
George, does that make sense to you? The periodic table of metallic dragons, does that make sense to you? Because it doesn't make sense to me. I don't know.
The periodic
that.
Table includes a section of metals, and then there are metal dragons in.
They're metal dragons.
Yeah, well, in Dungeons and Dragons, and so it's a sort of a melding of these two concepts. There wasn't one for you in there, just so you know.
Oh, a shirt for me?
Yeah, there was only the one for me. So.
Oh, really?
Okay. Yeah, but there's a T-shirt that explains this one that I'm going to have made for you.
Okay, and I'll wear it. Will you wear that shirt? Do you think you'll wear that shirt?
Sure. Yeah. Okay.
Put it on right now. I don't think I've ever seen you shirtless before.
I like you kind of lulled him into set the trap and then sprung it.
Have you guys seen? I think I've seen. We've had this conversation, I think, before.
Last week.
I think you're the only one I haven't seen shirtless yet.
If all goes well, that will continue until my death.
So
I got big plans for you not seeing me without a shirt on.
Okay.
Oh, maybe George's deathbed, he'll be lying in the coffin to peel off his shirt.
Oh, and I could just like lift up his shirt a little bit, so I could take
a
look.
If rigor mortis hasn't set in, you know, we'd need some scissors to cut it off. But
George, can you add to your will that it's an open casket and that like people can be free to touch as much as they want?
I'd like to be buried shirtless and with the top part open.
Okay, good.
Yeah. Hey, Evan Bingham, who we actually hung out with, he and his lovely wife in Indianapolis before a show. Genesee Cream Ale. We mentioned it during the state jingles. It's on the New York State jingle flag. Great jingle. And just as a reminder of how that went.
I forgot how it went.
Yeah.
Next time that you're thirsty, make Jenny Cream your brew. The taste is something different. It's smoother drinking too.
I like it. Cause there's nothing.
It's different.
Genesee Cream Ale.
So, solid jingle. I think we all remember why it was so great.
And also, it's different is like something you say, like, if you don't like something.
Yeah.
It's different. It's different.
Yeah. How's that cream ale? It's different.
Not for everyone.
But, it's unique.
We know Evan has been playing on around with his Moog keyboard synthesizer. And with wife on vocals, this is his version of the Genesee Cream Ale jingle.
Next time that you're thirsty, make Jenny Cream your brew.
Oh, I love that Moog.
The taste is something different. It's smoother drinking too.
Smooth as hell. Heck yeah.
Solid,
with the fade out too. Yeah. I really like that. Wow.
And not just that, they reenacted the whole thing. They got the sea queen.
was Evan and Sarah. That was Evan and Sarah. They were
they both
doing that. They did the whole thing. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Thank you, Evan and Sarah. Gorgeous.
Nice work. Smooth as hell.
We got a longer one in here. So, you know, we have these t-shirts that are hard to explain. That's the whole premise. So we had Sofa Bed Conspiracy, we have Lindo Man, and we have Hot Rock, which is the current one.
We just put in the order for Hot Rock.
Oh, good. So, but Tom wrote in, and it sounded sort of a long email. So I asked George if he could recreate this or do a dramatic reading of Tom's email to us with some visuals.
Well, first, let me ask, would you say it's Lindo or Lindau?
I always say Lindo because it looks like window.
Okay. No, I just wanted to say it correctly in my dramatic recreation so that I didn't have to eat.
We'll exempt you from Batman cereal.
Well, not so fast.
Well,
fast. I didn't agree to that.
Okay.
All right. I'll throw on this Wii.
Okay. So here's his email. I purchased the Lindo Man t-shirt earlier this year and rehearsed an explanation for curious shirt gazers, but I was tested in a way I never expected. I was eating dinner in the English Lake District when a woman sat at the table beside me and introduced herself as one of the academics who has dedicated her career to researching Lindo Man. She focused on the "We Want You Back" tagline, questioning me on the ethics of taking historical artifacts to distant museums. I had no choice but to back the t-shirt's corner, even though I completely disagreed with it. She even suggested that she had enough sway to actually return Lindo Man to his home, presuming the t-shirt signified a popular movement for his replacement. I felt the ethereal force of 30 tone-deaf children backing me in every argument, representing them to the point of violating my own beliefs. We continued the discussion for 30 minutes, and with the conversation leading to the ethics of showing a corpse such as Lindo Man in a museum, and where we draw the line on studying dead people and respecting their bodies. The experience was exhausting and unexpected. I know you said the t-shirts are hard to explain, but I wasn't expecting it to be that hard.
Wow. So that was a real encounter. And
that was
George. Good job.
That was a real email that we got, though. Like, that wasn't like a bit. Like, he actually got in an argument with somebody about his t-shirt. So, yeah, everybody buy a t-shirt and you can get into an argument with a stranger.
They're very hard to explain.
Yeah, they are. We got more of those too. If you have a long, let's call them long walk stories, you know, okay. Like, cause it's always a long walk to explain that shirt. If you have a long walk story, send it in to us. We got another one that I'll be presenting next week. Chris was wearing his sofa bed conspiracy shirt and had to explain it to a woman at a local county fair.
Oh, great. So, these are fantastic. I love them.
Exactly. So, Nick, do we want to announce what our next one is going to be? Because I think we already figured it out what it's going to be.
Yeah, let's announce it. Yeah.
Okay, we're going to do Rock's Winning Workout Without Weights because that logo is so great. It goes Rock's Winning Workout Without Weights. It's a great shade of blue. We might make it a tank top only, or maybe we make a tank top and t-shirt. Maybe we can do both. But anyway, Rock's Winning Workout Without Weights.
Let me bring that. I just pulled that up so we can see what that looks like.
Yeah, but I mean, the color, because it's like yellow font on like a heather
blue
shirt.
Can you see that okay?
Yeah, right there. Yeah. Great colors and very hard to explain. So, yeah.
All right, that's the next one. Yeah, we might skip over a male nipple. It was a fun idea. I don't know that a lot of people would order that shirt.
Maybe we could do it as like a different thing, like socks or something.
Enamel pins that you put on your nipples. I don't know, something
that you can pierce your nipples with.
Oh, that's an even better idea.
Oh, nipple rings.
Yes.
Let's say male nipple.
They'd say Gary, the Gary pins, but you're for your nipples.
You get Rusty Gary's. Okay. Well, you know,
somebody
from Eau Claire actually wrote in and told me that, hey, look, I'm a man with male nipples. And you told me to write in. So I'm writing in and I'll, when we unveil those, I'll see if he would wear them. Because if he even this guy with the nipple rings would wear some.
What did we ask? We asked, like, why would you get your nipples pierced? Like, what's the end?
Yep.
Okay.
And he said he liked how it looked, and he said there is some sort of sexual pleasure involved with it. So
really?
Some sort of sensitivity, I guess. So
are you exploring it, Nick? Are you looking into it? Are you going to find out if he's full of shit or if he's... if he's onto something, are you going to let us know?
Taking his word for it. Do you want to share what happened when we played Rhode Island College, Joe?
Yes. Okay. So this ties into state jingle. So we were, we did a show at Rhode Island College like 2 weeks ago. And Rhode Island, we already tackled that state for jingles. It was the Warwick Mall where Steve had his first French kiss ever. Here's just a reminder of what that song sounded like.
If it's now, if it's new. It's here in store for you, Warwick Mall.
Warwick Mall.
You'll find so much more.
I mean,
everything
this is
you're
90s
looking
right
for.
Here.
Warwick Mall. There's something for everyone.
Solid Warwick
Mall. Always something happening. Come in and join the fun. There's something for everyone at Warwick Mall.
Steve, so you actually French kissed in the Ann Taylor? Is that where you French kissed? Your first French kiss ever was at the Ann Taylor.
It was at the Ann Taylor.
Okay. Yep. No more.
No, I know that this wasn't the mall where you French kissed for the first time, but have you ever French kissed anybody in the Warwick Mall?
I don't think so. No.
Okay. All right. No further questions. All right. So, and then everybody remembers this picture of Nick, right? At Red Robin. I took a photo of him at Red Robin.
There's
low angle. He wasn't. Yeah, there's a backstory. Oh. So he didn't like the photo. I put it up on his Facebook page a few times, and then all of a sudden he unfriended me, and we haven't been friends on Facebook ever since. And it's been a big loss for both of us.
All of a sudden, unprompted, I unfriended you. How did it happen? Why? You're still searching for answers.
And it's just a big loss for both of us. I don't get to see Nick's updates. He doesn't get to see mine.
Yeah. How do we ever keep up with each other?
Anyway, we're on our way up to this Rhode Island College show. And we saw a certain something. I'll just let the video play. Okay, so we're driving on the interstate. We're on our way to Rhode Island College, and we saw this. Nick pointed at the side of the road, and I immediately crossed over 7 lanes of traffic to go here. I almost killed ourselves. But look at where we are now. Right here.
Now, don't do the low angle.
Let's get low.
Don't do the low angle.
There's
the... Well done, gentlemen.
Yeah, so yeah. More or less, that's nice things for this week.
Yeah, nice-ish things.
Mm-hmm. Well, huge things coming up on Thursday for the EP mode. If you're a $10 and up patron at patreon.com/foundfootagefestival, part two of Mr. T's Be Somebody or Be Somebody's Fool. And the big thing is I'm going to try to learn how to smoke during this one.
Yeah, exactly. There's one segment in there where Mr. T talked about peer pressure and about, like, you know, kids are going to get you to want to get you to start smoking. I guess I don't remember anybody like really pushing cigarettes on me that hard.
No.
You know, like, I feel like it might have been fabricated a little bit for these educational films.
Yeah.
But I think most people who smoke just kind of figured it out on their own. Anyway, we talked about smoking, and Nick and I have made some short films in the past, and he'll sometimes play the bad kid and he'll have to smoke a cigarette. He has no idea how to smoke a cigarette. And I'm just going to show you an example right here. We made a short film called Young Man's Guide to Dating. When did we make this? Like 2000?
1999, I think.
1999, like we were in Minneapolis. We made this thing. Nick played the bad kid. It was like a Goofus and Gallant kind of a thing. It was like a 1950s hygiene film. Young Man's Guide to Dating, and Nick played the goofus. He was the one who didn't do things correctly, and he smoked. Watch the way he smokes here.
Yeah, it's
not good. Watch this.
That goes for you.
Like, look at it. He just inhaled right there, and it immediately came out of his mouth. There's
it
me.
Felt like I was smoking.
Right. Watch. He pulls it into his mouth and immediately exhales it.
And that goes for you too, Darren. Perhaps your failure has taught you a lesson about proper respect.
That's not how you do it.
You did get one out of your nose, actually, which is pretty impressive.
That's what I was trying to do. Yeah.
Yeah. But it's as soon as you're pulling it in, you're blowing it out.
It's almost like it's a toxic cloud that his body is trying to get rid of.
So you're going to teach me how to do a smoke a proper cigarette for the first time.
Exactly.
On Thursday night at Patreon.
Finally, Nick Purr becomes a man.
Yeah. So weigh in on what kind of cigarette you think I should smoke. I'll pick up a pack. They're only.
I thought you were going to get Cools.
Well, okay, I'll get Cool.
You wanted to get menthol.
Yeah,
I think you would actually like menthol because you always like mint chocolate chip. You always like mint flavor. You always get the what's that fucking candy called?
Mint scented soap and
yeah, what's that? Junior mints. You always get junior mints.
Yeah.
And so
I think it applies to cigarettes too.
Okay, but you're actually going to follow my instructions. It's not going to be I can't do it. You've got to actually follow
I will try, but I also don't want to get sick and like hack for the rest of the episode.
No, so. You're going to get a great buzz, which you're going to get. You're going to like it. Yeah. You're going
to
like it.
Well, tune in to find out whether I'll like it. But also, Saturday morning, we're watching Hammerman, the MC Hammer cartoon, with Oakland's own Roy Miles, otherwise known as the Ghetto Geppetto on Instagram. He does puppetry and has some incredible Hammerman merch. I didn't even know there was any, but has it.
And plus he's from Oakland, which is where Hammerman, well, MC Hammer is from.
Yeah.
Hammerman is a fictional character. Right. MC Hammer is a real person.
Yeah. So it was really fun. We talk a lot about Hammer and our history with it. And of course, tomorrow on twitch.tv/foundfootagefestival at 10 a.m. Eastern, George and I will be here in the office. Should I pull this off so you can see what's behind here?
Oh, see the magic? Oh, yes. I see a U-line box.
Yep, there's a U-line box and all sorts of... That's the big reveal, everybody. There's not much behind here. But yeah, it's subscribe to Twitch so you get alerted. And we will be watching for probably 14 hours from 10 a.m. to midnight, all 26 episodes of season 2 of ALF, because tomorrow is the 35th anniversary of ALF. And to commemorate that, I have a little promo that aired in 1990 for ALF.
It's here, ALF's galaxy of greatest hits.
Ebony and ivory.
So pump up the comedy volume with ALF.
Weeknights at 6:30 on TV 38.
There it is.
Oh, that's a great promo, actually.
I love that promo, yeah.
That actually worked.
Yeah.
I'm excited about this one. I'm in Los Angeles now, but I'm going to definitely tune in just to see how George does. And like, George, did you bring your own straight jacket so you can put it on when you start feeling a little nutty? Or will you just wait for the guys in the white coats to bring the straitjacket for you? Because you're probably on a first name basis with them and they probably know your size.
I think
that this could turn out very differently than we expect. I think I might take the lead in the Let's Annoy Nick sweepstakes. I feel like I really rein it in around you guys, but 14 hours is a long time.
What do you mean? You rein in what?
My, all my
eccentricities?
Yes, everything. I rein in everything.
Oh, wow.
So I think.
Because we only see you for like an hour and 15 minutes each
as,
week.
As I plan. Can,
but not for 14 hours.
No, when you've said, oh, let's go to, you know, come with us on a, on like a long drive or something. I say I have something else going on. It's usually a rubber room is involved, but I, you know, and well, I get it all out there.
Here's the other thing is that I always want to have on people who, you know, like your brother or like your bandmate from Overlord. And you're always just like, nah, I don't want to have them on because they know something about you that we don't. And maybe tomorrow during this ALF thing, we're going to see that thing that you've been hiding from us.
Cracks
for so
in the
long.
Veneer. We'll see.
Tune in for that or ALF.
And also they'll be playing ALF.
Yeah. We already did a test and George is like, yeah, you know, I don't know if I'll be able to even get my work done because my work's going to know. It's not hidden that I'm going to be for 14 hours, but I'm supposed to be working. Going to be watching ALF on a weekday, so you could get called into work tomorrow. We'll see.
So on a Wednesday afternoon, two grown men well into their 40s.
On the wrong side of 45.
And Steve said he may join us for a little bit of it too, right, Steve?
Yeah, I'll swing by.
You're going to swing by? Oh, I wish I were there. I would love to, yeah.
Joe, I don't want you to be jealous of the amount of time I'm spending with Nick. I want you to know that I've been planning for
that's the problem.
For a spin-off show of you and me. It's called CSI My Toilet. And this is the promo I've got for it.
Oh, I like this. Yeah. Cool. Is it similar to Turd Flush at all? Do you know? Is it like
it's in the same genre? But it's just, you know, Nick has ALF that he's interested in, and you're interested in bodily functions, and I assist you in each of you in these.
And we do that for 14 hours. We watch it for 14 hours.
Well, Joe, follow-ups. We are accepting call-ins, so go ahead. Call us. During.
Should I just call your phone numbers?
Yeah, just call our phone numbers, yeah. And also, but getting out, we'll see Mr. T try to encourage a doughy child not to smoke, just to... I don't know. I guess tease Thursday's big smoking event.
Wet the whistle.
Patreon. Yeah.
I'm going to be doing the opposite. I'm going to be encouraging you. I'm going to tell you why you like cigarettes.
You'll be the teens. Other you'll be the older kids. And guess no one will be Mr. T in this. But until then, we'll be right back right after that.
Yeah. If we had been prepared, we could have done better.
Congratulations to Mike and everybody else at the Yeti for 10 years. Go to theyeti.com, spelled like as above. And my nose isn't full of yuck anymore.
See you sometime soon, and we'll talk. TikTok, let's talk again. Bye bye.
Everyone wants to be accepted by the group, but that doesn't mean you have to accept everything the group does. Hi.
When we return, Dr. Selmer will complete the bunion surgery.
Yes, those are his pajamas he's wearing.
All right, I gotta go.
That's all. That's it.
Let me see that one.
Rocks are done. Gotta sleep. Bye.
That's it. That it had done.
We did our best. If we'd been prepared, we could have done better.
What do you think about Bibra?
About what?
In
my nose isn't for yuck anymore.
Ooh. That's all I'm doing.
Cheerio.
Tinkerbell.
We'll be right back right after that.
And Kurt Polster, the real great guy.
Night, night.
Goodbye.
Jim's coins in Hilda.